Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Osteo Med, a series of video lectures on YouTube. The topic we are covering today is Skull, Norma, Basalis, Part 3. Here we cover the posterior part or the occipital part. This slide reconfirms the three areas of discussion. We have finished the first two and now we are left with the third part. So at the cost of a little repetition, roughly we divide the norma basalis into three areas or three parts: anterior, middle, posterior. You can also call it as face, sphenotemporal region, or the occipital region. In part 1 we have covered the face, in part 2 we have covered the sphenotemporal region, and now let's start discussing the posterior or the occipital part. Now that's the region for today's discussion, the area shown by the dotted rectangle. Let's see an enlarged view of that area. Now the most outstanding item that is virtually a very dominant thing in this is the foramen magnum, a large gap through which the brain is in continuity with the spinal cord. Plus there are a lot of other structures along with that, for example the meninges, the vertebral artery, the apical ligament, a number of additional structures which pass through the foramen magnum. Next, other than the foramen magnum, the squamous occipital, that is the flat part of the occipital bone, forms the bulk of this surface, with the exception that at the lateral edges, a small part of the mastoid temporal is seen. We can see the articulation at the lateral edges. Therefore, the squamous occipital is the major area. There is also an element of mastoid process of the temporal bone at the periphery. Next, at the posterior most end of this photograph is a very prominent midline landmark, the external occipital protuberance. Rising as a ridge on either sides from here is the superior occipital superior nuchal line. There is a vertical line called the external occipital crest which runs down from the external occipital protuberance to the foramen magnum. Roughly midway through this line, another transverse ridge called the inferior nuchal line emerges on either sides. That means we have external occipital protuberance, superior nuchal line, external occipital crest, inferior nuchal line. These are the structures we need to identify. Next, as I mentioned earlier, the mastoid process is seen at the periphery of this part. At the edges of the foramen magnum are two occipital condyles, the right and the left occipital condyles. In this view, they marginally move into or encroach upon the borders of the foramen magnum, very marginally, a few millimeters. Lateral to these occipital condyles is the jugular process of the occipital bone, which contributes to the posterior part of the jugular fossa and the jugular foramen. The foramen is not very clearly visible in this, but I will show you another photograph where the skull is more tilted and it gives you a better view. The large foramen you see in front of the jugular is the inferior opening of the carotid canal. Next, The styloid process is a small horn-like projection projecting down from the lower part of the mastoid area. Right behind it and between that and the mastoid, between the styloid and the mastoid, there is a foramen, the stylomastoid foramen, important because the facial nerve emerges from this foramen. In the vicinity of the condyles, the occipital condyles, there are two fossae or foramen, an anterior and a posterior condyle or canal. These canals lead into the foramen. The anterior condylar canal is leading to the hypoglossal foramen, through which the 12th cranial nerve emerges from the cranial cavity. The posterior condylar canal ends in an foramen, emissary foramen, through which an emissary vein is transmitted. This is the other photograph I told you, where the jugular foramen and the jugular fossa are well seen. You can see the jugular process forming the posterior margin of both the fossae and the foramen. Also seen right above the anterior part of the condyles, the hypoglossal foramen. Leading into it is the anterior condylar canal. That was an overview of the posterior part or the occipital part of the Norma basalis. You are welcome to give me your feedback. You can send it to me at this email ID, or you can write it in the blog area immediately below the YouTube video. This was a presentation from the Anatomy Department, St. John's Medical College, Bangalore. Also available in this series is a set of 90 plus lectures on histology, human histology. It is in this web channel, in the YouTube channel called VBS Histomed. You can subscribe to this channel, and also you can click on the bell so that as and when new videos are added, your notification will reach you. Now that's the channel VBS Histomed, a collection of histology videos useful for students of medical, dental, nursing, physiotherapy and allied health courses. Thank you for your patient hearing.